Okay, so in this episode, we have to start thinking about diversification of my channel. Now, there's some stuff I can't show here that I would love to divulge, but I can't show it here. So we're going to start a Patreon channel so I can give you all the ins and outs of all the things you've been asking me, but I couldn't answer on YouTube. But one of the first steps to do that is to get a macro machine that's going to help me manage all the systems here. Now, I'm going to be getting different 4K cameras, some lights for that. And one of the first things I wanted to get was the Elgato Stream Deck XL version. Now, this is an advanced stream control with 32 customizable buttons for both Windows and Mac, and that's coming up. Hey, what's up guys? This is Herve from Herve's World, showing you that IT means I try. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. Don't forget to subscribe. So on this channel, we do unboxings, desktop support, life hacks, actual hacking, and tech reviews of great products. Now, we're going to be using the Elgato Stream Deck XL. As you guys have seen, we have the 6-1, we have the 15-1, but now we're going to get the 32 version so that we can cross compare all of them for you guys, but also to give me functionality and macro control of the whole studio I'm gonna have here. Now I'm gonna start with Elgato's process by getting some interior lights there, setting up cameras around here, and you guys will be along for the process. So do me a favor, hit that like button, hit subscribe, and you'll see every question that you guys ask me step by step that I couldn't answer. We'll do it there on Patreon. Anything discussed in this episode, you'll find right on the bottom right over here. So let's go take a look at the Elgato Stream Deck XL version. Let the unboxing begin. Now, first of all, if you're not familiar with the Elgato Stream Deck, well, you can use it for, it's usually used for streamers, for YouTubers, but this is going to be something that's going to be really, really good. Now, I use one at work. It helps me navigate things that I have to do that are repeatable, things that I can pre-program in. You can just tap a button and it's gonna be there. Now, this is the XL version of that Stream Deck. This goes for $249 and it should be a lot bigger. So we'll compare and contrast between the big and the small version, but these have become more invaluable to me because I'm able to do so much more with them. A lot of things about this are really cool. Now I hadn't used these for a while, but once I figured out how you can use this and integrate it for my YouTube setup and my actual job, I'm an IT technician, this became a tool, a very powerful tool for the things that you have to repeat to people at a click of a button. Websites you have to go to, any username and password for admin sites, automatically on with the button. So it's a really great tool. Now this will have advanced live production, which you can easily control your favorite tools and platforms. Now it has 32 customizable keys, which will instantly trigger the unlimited actions for your tap. Now, you will also get powerful integrations with Elgato Game Capture, OBS, Streamlabs, Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, Mixer, Spotify, Philips Hue, vMix, VoiceMod, and so much more. These are very, very powerful. You'll also get one-touch operations where you can change scenes around, change camera angles, tweak your lighting, adjust audio, or you can post, hey, I'm going to YouTube Live or going to Twitter Live right now without having to type it out. Hit a button and it'll automatically execute it. Also, you will get visual feedback to know that your command has been executed. So gamers and podcasters have been using this tool to set off their platform to make one control integration for everything that they need. Now, I'm going to be starting a Patreon channel because the YouTube platform has been a little limiting for some stuff that I want to show you guys. And you've asked for very specific stuff that I can't really show, but I'm going to do that there. So I'll give you details in the next coming videos. So let's take a look at this. Now these are very easy setup. This here is actually a magnet. So you see how easily it goes together. Really a powerful tool. This is the Elgato Stream Deck Mini, and this is the XL version. It absolutely dwarfs it. Now, one of the reasons why you would want to have integrations that are larger, because you could then, you don't have to go into different folders to grab more stuff. As you see here, there are different actions that you can take, but everything's at your fingertips. And you could drill down into different items, but here, with the command center at your disposal, I think it'll be an easier platform for me here. And if I wanted to remove the height texture, well, I could bring it down like so, which I think I may prefer to be down here, but it's okay, it's a big desk. So we'll rock it like this for a little bit. Okay, so let's get to setting this up. Okay, now this is the back end of the Elgato Stream Deck. And all we have to do is you can program it for websites or text. And all you do if you want to do a website, you grab. It's drag and drop. Pop it in. You program the website that you want. And you can name it whatever you want. So I'm going to call this We can call this Studio. And then you can go in and you can actually set a file, create an icon, or open a Stream Deck icon library, which I'll show you here. And you can see a plethora of different items that you can pop in just to populate anything that you want at your fingertips. So it's really good at icons. If you type YouTube, it'll show you the YouTube stuff right here. So this is Studio. And as you see, Studio's right
okay.
there. Now this is the back end of the Elgato Stream Deck. And all we have to do is you can program it for websites or text. And all you do if you want to do a website, you grab. It's drag and drop. Pop it in. You program the website that you want. And you can name it whatever you want. So I'm going to call this Okay, so the next step is I want to control my lights via the Stream Deck. So we're going to go in, we're going to add Nanoleaf lights, we're going to add manually, we're going to enter in our IP. I have a Netgear app that's going to allow me to see every device and their IP. Now we're going to press the button. And now that it's in pairing mode, all you do is you tap devices in pairing mode. And the Nanoleaf has been successfully paired. You hit done. And we can call this on off. Okay, so let's try it. We're gonna go to the Nanoleaf here. And we're going to hit the on off. Yep. It works. You can see exactly. Essentially, all you need to do is to grab the effect. You pop in the effect. You go in and you can add the effect that you want. So we're going to populate this with all of the settings that I have here. And then we can see exactly what it is. What I'll do is we'll name it so we know exactly what it is. Okay, so now
What I'm doing is I'm actually writing the names and title so that when I look at it, I can see it.
Okay, so we have everything filled out. Everything resides in its own little folder. So if we do this, we have all our lights here. So I have all the pulsating ones on top. We tap. You can see just the different gradients in the room and really cool. So this is light cycle. Ooh. Nightclub. Pretty cool. Nightclub 2. But as you see here, you can see exactly how it goes.
Well, that's gonna do it for this episode. The Elgato Stream Deck XL is going to be very instrumental here because we are going to be putting forward-facing lights, cameras on the other side to stream on Patreon, which I'll let you know very, very soon, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So don't forget to like and subscribe. If you have any questions, now that we have all three Stream Decks, I'm gonna do a comparison of the XL, the 6-button one, the 15-button one, and the 32 for you guys. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace. Can you do peace? Put your fingers like this. Say peace.
Peace.
Bye.
Bye.
Say bye.
Bye.
Subscribe.
Subscribe.
Subscribe. Subscribe. That's right. Catch you guys in the next one. Bye.
Bye.